Hello, I'm working on garlic mustard. So we harvested in the garden and now I'm rinsing it. So I rinse quite a bit and I just want to show you the last one that I'm going to work on. And let me close this since then I'll put the water in it. So we harvested in the garden on April 25, which is today. And if you don't know garlic mustard, it is a type of wild mustard but smell like garlic. So you can see the leaves. And already it starts setting bud for flower and seed. Later, or late spring. So I'm just going to rinse it, and I think I have enough water here. And we harvest a bucket. We harvested a bucket of it in just one small part of the garden. That's just the way I rinse them, and I remove the leaves off of the stem to make sure I don't have other weeds in it. So pretty much what I use it for, it'll grow in anything that I cook that I like to put greens in. It could be soup, it could be even like egg roll. I don't put cabbage in egg roll. We like to call it wrap. I'll put greens. Any other greens that I have in it. So you can see the water, that the water is not dirty or there is no bug or anything like that. So it's early in spring, we don't have bug issue yet. And then that's a plant that is not bothered by bug either. So now we have it here. And as you can see, I work on this. Maybe it's a little bit too close to you, but that's pretty much a bucket of ice cream, an ice cream bucket, and that's a gallon. So we have about a gallon that I harvested from the garden. That's weed edible. And if I assume that I will need 1 gallon, like I will use 1 gallon of greens a week, then how many greens that I need to stock up for winter. So we can assume that, and there's something that I came across because I'm working on soup. In fact, instead of putting this here, I'll put it in the soup. But when I was working on the soup, that's chicken soup, you can see that I have chicken and broth here that I canned in 2017. So I'm trying to use them up as well. And I have green pepper here. It must have been on sale at the grocery store last year in May. And this came from the garden almost a year. Tomorrow will be a year ago that I harvest this from the garden and chop it up. That's onion. So I put them in the pot and I'm out of greens. Like today when I was making wrap, I went in the freezer. I went to the freezer and look up because I have a freezer just for vegetables, and I saw 2 small bags of greens, like broad leaf plantain. That's a weed as well, a medicinal one, but it's edible. You can be eat like in salad as well. So I used that, and I believe I saw something else. I don't know if that's sorrel. It might be sorrel. So just a little bit left over of those two, and I add it to what I cooked for lunch, which was the egg roll or wrap. So I'm out of greens that I stock up last year, but I have 2 gallons. I just show you onion. That's a gallon bag. So I have 2 of that, and I took 1 out to put some in the soup that I'm making. So that means I have less than 2 gallons of onion, And onion is a lot in the garden already. I can start harvesting and freezing. And so since I harvest them in April last year, so that means that around April, I usually start harvesting things for the freezer. So that means we might need to rely on our freezer from November to April, and that's 6 months. So if I need to stock up for 6 months in vegetables, and I assume that I can use, not that I usually use that much, but I'll use 1 gallon of greens a week, so that's 4 gallons a month, and that would be 4 times 6, that would be 20 gallons. So that means if I can fill up this bag 20 times by the end of the season, then I have enough greens for winter, pretty much for half a year. So that's how I make calculations, and sometimes I don't get it right. I stock up on sweet corn last year because the store, each time is on sale at the store, I will buy and I will stock up on that. We still have a lot left, so we didn't use a lot in winter either, so we have that. And all the greens like this, I'm out of it, so which is good because now we have it in the garden, we can start eating from the garden. So this one, I'm just going to chop it up and put it in the soup. And the soup is not going to be a lot. It's 1 quart jar of chicken, 1 quart jar of broth. Put green pepper and green onion in it. So let's go check it out. I have not even turned it on yet. So I can do that. And that's my green here. Probably a cup. And I'll just add it to my chicken soup. And by the way, that's rhubarb. When I went to check the freezer for greens for my egg roll during lunchtime, I noticed that I have some gallons of rhubarb there, and I took some out, made a crust, and just cooked the rhubarb and added to and bake it. So that's big pie right here. And the rhubarb came from the garden. That's one thing that if I don't grow it, I won't purchase rhubarb to make pie. Never done it before. I don't know if I'll do it. And now that I'm pressing it down, it's still more than half this when I press it down, because the gallon is here. It's pretty much this line here. So even I'm pressing it down, it's more than half the gallon. But before I do that, what I like to do is I have this bag here. I like to date my bag and put the greens that is in it. And I'm not going to blanch my greens. I don't blanch my greens anymore. Don't even know how many times I have done it before. I just simplify the process of things, because here's the things. I have shown you the garlic mustard in the garden, and I'm going to be pretty much get a notebook and write down each time I fill a gallon of greens. That way I know how many gallons of greens that I have. So pretty much what I'm going to do today is, why my pen is not writing? When I need pen, I have kids that would like to take it. So 25, 20. And oh yeah, the other one is 29, right? It's 4 days before that'll be exactly a year. So garlic. Oh, why this thing is not writing? Garlic mustard. It's kind of weird, but I don't know. Can you read it? So yeah, I need to be able to read it months later, right? I have to figure out what pen is going to write on it. So the way I just calculated how many greens I need to stock up for winter, which turned out to be that before my garden will have enough of green for me to start relying on the garden next season, will be about April. I need to have 20 gallons, pretty much 20 of these. Is it 20? It should be 24, right? 4 times 6 is 24. 24 of that. So I'll just be writing it down. And I don't know if I'll be able to go outside to do that again, to try to harvest a bunch of it to make another gallon. But I don't know. It's getting late. It's just 5 though. But, and I'm not chopping it too small or anything. And it's good to take all of those things off. That way when you are cooking something in winter time, that does not, is just going to be a quick cook. You don't want to have those stems that will be hard in it when you are eating it. So it's just better to take a short time now and get them out. And you'll notice that I didn't take those things off. Yeah. And when the little one on. Yeah, it's bitter. Very bitter. Which means it's good for us. It's very strong. And you can see that's a lot of green. And I'm not done. Still have some here. And as I said before, I'm not going to steam anything. I'm stocking up for winter. And I'm going to use them all. So within a year, hopefully. And it speeds the process for not trying to flash cook it before putting it in the bag. Mommy. Yes, Jaden. Il faut dire à Angélique de faire attention. That's a lot of green. I don't know if you can see it, but that's a lot of green. So I'm going to get my bag. And I like to, in fact, I'll ask my husband if they have the other tap that you just pinch to close, if it's cheaper to get it from, if they have it. During this time, there is few things you can, it's not much you can find in the store, so just have to go with what you can. So early this month, I asked him to get me freezer bag because I know that pretty soon I will start harvesting things from the garden. And I'm glad that I did it because now garlic must start to flower. So it's usually I can put it in the salad around this time. But when they start sealing, I can cook with the leaves. But I don't put it in salad. Unless I can find small leaves from the tip. So you can see it's really a gallon. You can see the greens. So what I like to do is I will take the head out of it. I don't even use fancy tool or you know those things that suck air out of things. I don't do that. I don't even have it. So I will just try to get the air out as much as possible. And I'll just seal it. And that's pretty much it. And I'll just, so when I'm putting things in the bag, I'll try not to pack it too much. Because when they are frozen, what I like to do is just break them apart. But you see the onion. So even if they are in chunks, it just be a chunk that I can just take apart. And I have this one too. So that's that. And I'll just put in the freezer. And I don't know if I'll be able to go out and try to get another one or just rest for the day. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Afiavi Ojune Liberman, creators of Liberman Consulting LLC YouTube channel and owners of Nina Soap. And our website is ninasoap.com. That's how I try to eat what is in our garden so that I can decrease our food budget and we could be able to live on one income and use the other income to pay our mortgage and pay off early. Thank you. Oh, there is something else I like to add as well is during this season, during this early spring like this, I'll find this in the garden. I'll have sorrel, I'll have creeping Charlie, I'll have dandelion. Those will I will be using to make salad. When this starts seeding, I'll have other weed that will grow and I'll use them for salad as well, like lamb squatter. It comes up in summertime. So I just forage in my garden to make salad throughout the season. Thank you.